Hello. I'm not Orson Welles. In fact, I'm not even remotely Orson Welles. But you would know that if you were looking at the video screen. Some of you may not know where the video screen is, so I would advise those of you who do not know where the video screen is to turn gradually to your left. Keep turning. Over here, towards the back of the room, just above the ladies' room. There we are. You see us now? Did you respond thinking I could hear you? Very good, then. Well, since that's all settled, we invite you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the horror, the heartbreak, and the tragedy that is Citizen McCoy. Oh, goddamn, I hate scotch! Well, don't drink it, then, you moron.
Rosebud. Rosebud. Rosebud! God damn it, Rosebud!
And so, in the end, as it must come for all men, death came for the world's most powerful man, Theodore Foster McCoy. Coming up next, Cameron Daddo hosts another outrageous hour of the world's worst electricians.
From humble beginnings, Theodore Foster McCoy rose to become possibly the most powerful man of the 20th century. He came to preside over an enormous empire that encompassed 564 newspapers, 2 syndicates, 17 television stations, and that little hat shop next to Flinders Street Station that no one ever goes into.
When he turned 25, he was expected to assume control of the McCoy Empire from his guardian, the crusty old Walter Parks Thatcher. But Theodore Foster McCoy had other ideas.
It's from Theodore. Dear Mr. Thatcher, sorry, but I'm not interested in uranium mines, shipping companies, or railways. Not interested! One item on your list, however, intrigues me. The Melbourne Inquirer, a little newspaper I understand we acquired in a foreclosure proceeding. Please don't sell it. I'm on my way back to Australia to take charge. I think it would be fun to run a newspaper. Fair enough. The boy has to live his own life. P.S. I'm engaged to Kate Fisher. I'm engaged to Kate Fisher! Ugh!
For over 50 years, the name of Theodore Foster McCoy was synonymous with power, wealth, and prestige. Many loved him, many more hated him. Some denounced him as a communist, others as a fascist. Still others called him a podiatrist, but those people don't count. But it was as editor of the Melbourne Inquirer, a struggling daily newspaper, that he made his greatest contribution.
We've made some good changes to this paper, but there's still something missing.
What are you going to do, Ted?
My statement of principles. Don't smile, Jed.
Got it all written out. You don't want to make any promises, Mr. McCoy. You don't want to keep.
Things will be kept.
I'll provide the people of this city with a paper that tells all the news honestly. And they're going to get the truth in the Melbourne Inquirer. Simply and quickly and entertainingly. And no special interests are going to be allowed to interfere with that truth. Except the gun lobby. And the Kennett government. And the banks. And BHP. Casino. Coles Meyer. Stonington Theatre Company. Rollo. The oil companies. ERA. Citylink. Microsoft. The AFL. Indonesia. And a bunch of ignorant farmers, but that's it!
Yeah. Woman gives birth to live ferret! Spanish galleon off the coast of Portsea! Quiz show admits to satanic sacrifices! Liberal party buys nukes from Gaddafi!
Stop, stop, stop. What are you doing? This is supposed to be Othello. Get out. Out of my theatre. Out.
Fake McCoys to play Wembley Stadium? Is this really your idea of how to run a newspaper?
I've no idea how to run a newspaper, Mr. Thatcher. I just draw anything I can think of. Anyway, don't criticize my newspaper. Its content displays only the highest quality of objective journalism without a hint of sensationalism or bandwagoning.
Extra, extra, get your Melbourne Inquirer here! Heroin, heroin, two-year-olds on heroin! Everybody's on heroin! Immigrants high on heroin are taking your jobs! And your heroin! Get your heroin free with your Melbourne Inquirer! Heroin! I said heroin!
Through his decades as a towering figure in public life, Theodore Foster McCoy seemed indestructible, bomb-proof, as it were. Until, one day, he went too far.
Sir, what's your response to the sexual harassment allegations?
Well, come now, a friendly little grope never hurt anybody.
Sir, what about those charges you've been illegally selling chemical weapons to the Taliban?
Well, they're absolutely true, but you're hardly going to prosecute me for that, are you?
What about the rumours of you commissioning pornography starring Mother Teresa?
Well, yes, I did that, but then again, who hasn't?
Sir, is it true you once ate a McDonald's fillet o' fish?
Why, certainly, and I found it most filling. What?
Boo! What?
Sick bastard!
It's on the menu, isn't it?
Boo!
This interview is over! Shamed and humiliated, McCoy retreated into the world he had made for himself.
Excuse me, sir. Your ex-wife, Kate Fisher McCoy Packer Warren Fairfax Vizard Boutros Ghali, is on the phone.
She's not really, is she? You just like saying her name. My order! Ah, it's all true. I'm deeply crap. Rosebud.
I'm sorry, sir. What did you just say?
I said Rosebud! It's a swear word I picked up while I was in the service. Doesn't actually mean anything.
Very good, sir.
That wasn't bad.
Yeah.
Bit far-fetched, I thought. Yeah, maybe.
That was Orson Welles' 1941 classic, Citizen McCoy, starring Christian Price, Patrick Stokes, and Ian D. Seymour. Coming up next, another crazy hour of the world's funniest fatal traffic accidents.